Hey guys, Nash here. So after getting many requests from you guys, finally I installed Android P DP file, which is a treble ROM. You can install this on any treble supported phone. So this is final developer preview file. After this, we are going to have Android P and many Android P ROMs. So in this video, we are going to have a look at Android P DP file. So let's get started. So guys, as you can see, this is DP5 beta 4 and this is almost stable build. Many bugs are fixed here and it is safe to say this is our daily driver ROM. So guys, this is a ROM, but this developer preview is officially available for Pixel, Pixel 2, Essential Phone and phones like Nokia 7 Plus. So OnePlus can't give you Android P developer preview, but phones like Essential and Nokia 7 Plus can give you this Android P beta. And that's quite strange. And let's not talk about Xiaomi or Samsung. Well, Samsung will think about Android P when Android R will be launched. And that is the reason your friend Nash here already flashed 300 custom ROMs in his life. So guys, jokes apart, let's talk about Android P DP5. So after this, they will launch Android P with a new name. Maybe Android P Starcio Ice Cream. But if you ask me, they should name it Android P Pani Puri. So first of all, let's talk about the lock screen. Lock screen is more cleaner now and the clock fonts are changed. The clock is more in the center than before. And guys, look at this wallpaper animation when you unlock your phone and when you lock your phone. Along with that, we get new rotation button, complete new design. So when you rotate your phone, you're going to see this button on your navigation bar and that's quite useful. And about new recent menu is working flawlessly, of course, with new navigation pill, and that is also working perfectly without any problem. And I'm getting used to all the Android P gestures because that's the future right now. And also Google has removed voice icon from this Google search bar, but don't worry, when you long press on this pill, you will activate Google Assistant, so that's neat. And every time you swipe right or left, you feel this haptic feedback. And that makes multitasking experience even better. And now let's talk about battery life. So obviously this adaptive battery feature is helping to get extra battery life. I personally got 9 hours of screen on time and that's a great ratio for a stock ROM. So guys, these are the major change and I'm really looking forward to Android P GSI final build. And now I will show you how you can install this ROM on your phone. So guys, first of all, you need to download all these files. And as always, everything will be in the description box below. And now it's time to boot into TWRP recovery. Currently I'm using TWRP exclusive which supports treble ROM. Link for that will be in the description box below. So once you are in TWRP recovery, make sure you take full Android backup in case anything goes wrong. And then go to wipe and perform factory wipe on your phone. And now we are going to install a base ROM. For base ROM, you can use any Oreo treble supported ROM. I already had Moki downloaded, so I'm going to install Moki treble ROM on my phone. Now this ROM is based on Android Oreo. So once it's installed, go to Mount tab and select vendor here. Now go to install tab, tap on install image and install this Android P GSI file into your system. So once that is done, go to your install tab again and install this GSH file 1, 2, 3. Make sure you install them in order. And now tap on reboot, and now you will have sweet, sweet Android P. First boot might take around 5 to 10 minutes, and if it takes more than that, perform this installation again or just simply restore your Android backup. So that is how you install Android P GSI on any Treble supported phone. And if you want to see future Android P ROMs video, then press the bell icon and like this video if you appreciate my work. This is your friend Nay signing out, and I will see you tomorrow.